everybody. Raul here for Bass Musician Magazine. And today we have the great honor of chatting with Mike Connolly from MJC Ironworks, who's going to share some thoughts on the great late Francis Rocco Prestia.
Francis Rocco Prestia. I've known him through other companies that I worked with for 35 to 40 years. He's as loyal a person as you've ever met in your life. His passing is just, it's horrible. Not a day goes by I don't think about him, but what we're really striving for is that he's not another great who passes away and his legacy goes with it. You know, when you hear the record, you think about it. We're going to do a commemorative, this isn't the package, but a commemorative bass set. We had developed at another company a signature Rocco set that actually, Rocco was so mad at me at one trade show when we introduced it. He had to sign 300 autographed pictures. Oh. And I can't use some of the words he used, but it was always, Connolly, why are you making me do this stuff? You know, I mean, we had sold like just thousands of this stuff. And it brings me to a point. There are so many unbelievable bass players out there who do things that we can only dream of. Patitucci, Steve Bailey on six string bass, fretless. I never heard anything like it. And it's not to take away from any of the other talents that are in that group. Victor Wooten, forget it. What planet is this guy from? I've seen him play where he started out at Reggie, his brother, who basically kind of gave him his techniques. Mm-hmm. It was in Nashville, and it was a little party for Reggie's students. And Victor played, he started off with, because he's a natural born teacher, and with a blues lick. And where that thing went in a half an hour, it was just, it went to places that mortal humans were not meant to go. But, you know, that being said, these are people that do things that we, ow, wow, you know, Jocko, wow. Rocco, Chuck Rainey, to me, is one of, as far as the groove, one of the greatest bass players ever lived or recorded, next to James Jamerson. And then comes our friend Rocco. He's so 16th note. People take this 16th note theory. And he did 16th notes, but it was what he didn't play. And I've had some just unbelievable experiences where he would show me the parts that he played. And, you know, I would say, Rocco, can you show me that? And he goes, he loved to give me crap. He'd go, I'll show you, Connolly, but you show me what you played first. And this song happened to be Credit. It's doom pa doom da doom da doom da doom pa da 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 da. So I had figured out the part, you know, going from the third to the fifth, climbing up. You couldn't have done it any more complicated than I did it. And he goes, give me the effing bass, Connolly. And he picked it up and he went, don't, 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 don't. And all the rest of that phrase, there was not a note. It was completely muted. But when you listen to it on a record with all the ghosting, you know, the pitch of the drums and the horns and, you know, whatever, it makes it sound like there's something in there that it isn't. And the perfect example is if you get a chance to hear or really listen to You're Still a Young Man, mm-hmm. There's things that he doesn't do on that and things that he does do that is 100% uniquely Rocco Prestia. And the thing about players like him and Chuck Rainey and James Jamerson, it's all attainable. You know, and it just makes you feel so good that, you know, because of his passing, we're doing a commemorative set that isn't going to just be a set of strings. There's going to be some, hopefully, we're looking to have maybe some lost tracks and a couple of those videos that we had done to make this thing really show you what this wonderful man was about. We're doing this in accordance with Berklee School of Music in Berklee, Massachusetts, mm-hmm. not California. ESP Guitars is in this as well.
Nice.
And the bass department, who Rocco had been to talk to the students many, many, many times. We're setting up a Rocco Prestia Scholarship Fund. Now, everyone is doing what they can right now until it's completely released. We are not going to stop. After we get through the commemorative series, we're going to have a Rocco series, bass string forever. And outside of, you know, what it costs us to make the string, all the profits go to the scholarship fund. We'll be discussing many ways just to keep him alive. And all my life, Raul, I did artist relations for 35 years. I've never met a bass player, whether it's Lacuna Coil or, you know, some kid down the street or a bass player in a gospel band who hasn't been affected by Rocco's playing. It's just so much further than I think what the perception of it is. So I dearly miss this man. And a great quick story I heard that Doc told. Doc is the baritone sax player.
Yeah.
He said they would have these rehearsals the night before they would go in the studio, and Rocco was on fire. He was just, oh my God. And Garibaldi and Mimi, they were all just, my God, you know, how great that was. But Rocco, the next day, wouldn't remember him.
Yeah.
So they'd have to try to, you know, coax it out of him because he was such a spontaneous player.
Yeah.
And some of the things, I was fortunate enough to be at a couple of recording sessions where I watched him before he had his liver transplant. And he had so much ammonia in his system that he just wasn't firing on all cylinders. And they were doing this one part in a song. I can't think of the name of the song, but he came in wrong.
Oh.
And it was like really wrong. They kept it in the song. And all the rhythm section accented that note in the song. And it was just unbelievable. How real a lot of things happened was really just by mistake. But I'll always miss Rocco as a person, and his influence on myself personally is boundless. I mean, there isn't anything that I do on the bass where there isn't some Rocco Prestia, some Chuck Rainey, some of the other greats. And we're going to be coming out with a Rainey string at some point. But it's just that his influence, grab a Tower of Power record and just listen to it, and your mind will be blown. He was, had one thing he did, and that was purely Rocco. And his personality was just, well, you know Rocco.
Yeah.
Just as spontaneous and hilarious and creative as his bass playing. I didn't mean his bass playing's funny, but anyway, such a great influence to all of us and truly missed. But, you know, we all can attain to be better people and make our life better because of influences like him. And just to make it a better world, because music is a language, and he happened to speak that language fluently, mm-hmm. as a lot of other people do. And we're all blessed to be in this business and be promoting music and playing music, because the way the world is now, Raul, it's the one thing that brings me, and I'm sure everyone else, joy. And that language of music, perfect example. I had a friend of mine who was in a pretty famous band, and they played in Brazil. And for some reason, they went out on some safari or something out into the middle of the jungle and found these tribes that didn't see, you know, back then, cassette players and things of this nature.
Yeah.
And they played what they considered good music, and everyone went right along with it. It's a language that is boundless. Mm-hmm. It's endless. And everyone understands it, though they don't speak the language. You know what I'm saying? It's not like a spoken language.
Absolutely.
And just music in general, we're all so blessed to be able to do what we do and have conversations like this. And I just want to give a quick shout out to you and Valerie.
Oh, thank you.
And Magazine. I don't know how many people get to know you or Valerie, but I can tell you that it's always a pleasure to talk to you guys. You're so in tune with what this industry is, and what you offer is how, in some ways, believe it or not, is how we look at our own website. You offer a service. You're not always out there in someone's face, you know, BOGO. You know, there's a couple of string companies, because I, you know, being in the string industry, I have to be up on what's going on, you know, out there. And I got to tell you that most of the stuff I delete, and it's unfortunate, but as long as I think that there's people like us, and there's a lot of us in a lot of the music industry who promote what we promote, the beauty of music and how it makes you feel, there's nothing else like it on the planet. And I wanted to thank you and Valerie for all you guys do and how much help that you do. You help for me, and I hope, I wouldn't hope, I know for all the other vendors that you're associated with, because I know a lot of them, and we talk about you over here.
There you go. Well, we love what we do, Mike, and we have passion about music and bass, and I think it just shows. I mean, it's like anything that you do. If you're not passionate about it, it just goes, eh, and that's all you get. Now, I want to come back to the Signature Strings estimated release time. I know I wouldn't hold you to it, because I know these are, a lot can happen between now and then, but.
Yeah, the whole project with all the entities, Berklee School of Music, the bass department, who I think, yeah, Steve Bailey runs it, ESP Guitars, MJC Ironworks, and some of the, Barbara and some of the other wonderful people that work at Berklee to bring these things together. It's at the beginning of it right now.
Okay.
So I would say for myself, it's going to be probably 2 or 3 months, maybe a little bit longer, that we, first of all, want to make sure that what we're making is perfect. And it is a Rocco string. This is something that was developed for Rocco. Unfortunately, he passed away before we had a chance to actually put it into production. So I'm going to say safely probably 4 to 6 months. If you go to the website, the Berklee website, and I imagine it's a bit complicated to navigate, but you get to the Rocco spot, it'll explain in a lot more detail than I can.
Excellent. And will you have information about it on your website, www.mjcironworks.com?
Absolutely, yes. That's why, you know, we're so careful about the emails, that we're not going to be abusing anyone's right to have an email address, and we're not going to be selling anything. It'll be informational stuff like this, or what you're actually reading something, and it's not like, oh man, hey, I need another, I can buy 3 cents and get one free.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, but once again, I just wanted to thank you guys and just tell you guys, and I mean this in the most manly of ways, I love you guys.
Thank you, Mike. You're awesome. And thank you for sharing your experience with Rocco. We're grateful that we could get to hear it. Folks, you've seen him here, Mike Connolly on Bass Musician Magazine.
Thank you very much, and enjoy your musical day.